Retired pro wrestler Dave Bautista's body has always been his instrument, but just how do the special effect magicians of Marvel transform a Titan of the Ring into an extraterrestrial soldier of fortune? The answer involves a lot more dental fakery, time in the sauna, and prosthetic sheeting than you might guess. Any artist will tell you that practice is key to mastery.
Do it again. I can't.
You do it again.
But if the artist's canvas is a person who has to eat, sleep, and live life outside the makeup chair, the best way to practice is to make a model and go to town on it. That goes for Batista's transformation into Drax, which begins with a model of his body, which includes his head, face, arms, and torso down to his hips. From this, the makeup team creates a clear plastic mold with holes to indicate where Drax's many tattoos and scars must be placed. The plastic mold is placed on Batista at the start of his makeup session, and a type of rice paper-based special effects makeup known as Skin Illustrator is airbrushed through the holes. The result is a map of where Drax's tattoos should be placed with an impressive level of precision, allowing the artist to access a portable, easily replicated starting point. This level of precision is essential to maintain continuity with a visually complex character like Drax. You may think it's easy to remember what color Drax is, but it's honestly pretty complicated. Compare how he looks in the sterile light of a spaceship to the warmer sunlight of Ego's home in Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. As it turns out, his hard-to-pin-down coloration is very much by design. Batista's body paint odyssey begins with a base coat of gray. Then, as makeup effects designer David White told Business Insider in 2014, we added thin layers of browns, reds, and greens within the base gray to break up the tone and make it come alive before the final color sweep. The green, brown, and red worked into his alien complexion are subtle but present. Infinity War and Endgame, which placed Drax beside far more human characters than ever before, made the artistry behind his design truly pop. The intricacy of Drax's tattoos presents a challenge. They're not quite like traditional tattoos, as they're raised in a fairly consistent shade of red, yet neither are they as random as battle damage or as uniform as purposeful body modification, like Killmonger's extensive scars. They are, like Drax, entirely unique and entirely alien. To create them, the makeup artists use 18 prosthetic pieces, placed onto the areas previously mapped out using Skin Illustrator and the plastic mold. Once applied, makeup is used to blend the prosthetics into Drax's skin, and a fan brush is raked across his body, turning the raised tissue of the prosthetics red. Few aspects of the outrageous look of the Guardians cast have presented the special effects team with more challenges than Drax's unique tattoos, and ultimately pushed them into ever more impressive levels of innovation. After the makeup is fully applied, one of the most difficult special effects problems rears its ugly head. How do you keep the makeup looking great for hours of shooting, through hot lights, unpredictable weather, bathroom breaks, and meals? Prosthetic makeup department head for Legacy Effects, Brian Sipe, explains the challenge to the makeup artist and hairstylist Local 706 website. Our enemy is heat and sweat, and we had heat from the lights, body heat from the actor, and the muggy Atlanta heat and humidity. Batista is brush sealed with a mixture of chemical and medical adhesive. Though this is a notoriously intense way of finishing off one's look, it's Hollywood's first choice, as it truly keeps even the most elaborate looks from smudging. It's the details that truly make a character design sing. Without her antenna and blank black eyes, Mantis wouldn't ride the line between adorable and just a tiny bit creepy so well. Without her pink highlights and facial grooves, Gamora might bring to mind asparagus rather than a fearsome alien warrior. So it goes with Drax, whose finishing touches have nothing to do with tattoos or blue body paint. Do you remember Drax's teeth? Probably not, but special care goes into making sure they look believably gross, as a bereaved warrior's teeth would likely be. Batista's teeth are too even and well-maintained to fit the bill, so a custom set of dentures transforms his pearly whites into dingy grays. Drax's eyes are just as impressive as the rest of him, and just as work-intensive. Tailor-made contact lenses transform Batista's dark brown eyes into Drax's ice blue ones. They're the sort of unearthly shade you only really see in television or movies. A blue so bright and cold it brings neon lights and phosphorescent algae to mind. In addition to this unusual color, the iris is encircled with a thin band of blood red. These shades bring Drax's gaze to the fore of the screen, echoing the blue, gray, and red color scheme of the rest of his body, while signaling to the viewer that there are buried layers to the Hulking brutes. After Drax has kicked butt, taken names, chopped a few aliens into pieces, and dropped a few devastatingly blunt quips, comes the final task, and it's a doozy. Excavating Dave Bautista from the many blended, airbrushed, glued, and sealed layers that make him into Drax the Destroyer. On the first Guardians of the Galaxy, the makeup team scrubbed it all off him with brute force. As Bautista told Cinema Blend, 2 days of this treatment made his skin, quote, like hamburger, and a better method was sought. The answer was found in a portable sauna.
Now I get in the sauna for about 20 minutes by myself, and then about three guys join me, and they start, scrubbing this makeup off.
Did anyone take video?
At the end of a day of shooting, Bautista sits in the sauna, raising his core body temperature and building up sweat, which loosens the makeup's hold on his skin. With the help of steam-pumping hoses, shaving cream, hot towels, and a silicone-based makeup remover known as 244 Fluid, Bautista is freed from Drax's shell. The routine for making Bautista into Drax has changed pretty dramatically over the years. Initially, on the set of the first Guardians movie, turning Bautista into Drax took a tedious 5 hours, during which he had to stand as still as possible. Taking the makeup off was another 2-hour journey unto itself.
They have these two sticks that they have, and they have tennis balls on top of them, and that's what I grab and perch my arms up on.
The Guardians sequel saw a dramatic streamlining of the process. His prosthetic tattoos were reduced in number from 27 to 18. The sauna was introduced, and removal fell to 70 minutes. Bautista told Screen Rant on the set of Volume 2, "It's so easy you wouldn't believe it. I'm not kidding, it takes like an hour and a half now. The last one, they got it down to 4 hours, and everyone was celebrating. This, literally, they attacked me with paint rollers all over. And it looks better, too. It looks way better. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about Marvel movies are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one."